And I'd like to ask law of karma. I don't want the theoretical question. I want the practical question and practical answer.
It's a very blunt question, but I have to give a blunt answer as well. You see, there are two approaches you can adopt. One is to do business with God. You see, we are Gujarati, Sindhis, we have a problem. You know, it's inbuilt in us. We like to do commerce, even with the idea of spirituality. So we say, oh Lord, I do this for you, now what are you giving me back? This is the wrong attitude. You give for the sake of giving. Whatever comes, let it come. And you see, it's not that because we have done something bad or evil that something happens bad to us. This is a very oversimplistic interpretation of the law of karma. You see, this is the world when you look around. There are so many good people struggling, suffering, who can't even have a clean glass of water to drink. And they are suffering and dying all around the world. What have they done wrong? You know, somebody say, oh well, you know, this little child born in the sub-Sahara desert, you know, because they are so uneducated, let them, they deserve to die. What has the poor little child done that he deserves to die without water? So, you see, never give simplistic interpretation to your religion. When you try and give this kind of simplistic answers, you really do tremendous harm to your religion or your understanding of your religion. Your religion never gave you this oversimplistic interpretation. It simply said, law of karma is simply this. Look, we all have to live with it. We can't avoid it. It simply says, objects and events are strongly interconnected. When you do certain things, some other things from outside also kind of interact, and then we produce certain results. There is, if you like, a link between objects and events that we see all around us. Everything seems to be connected with everything else in a very intricate manner, not in a simplistic manner. Millions of causes had to combine together for me to sit here and talk to you. So it's not that simple that I can say, oh, this is why I'm talking to you. Millions of things had to conspire together to produce this result. This is the law of cause and effect in its complexity. It's not a simplistic idea. But causation is at the heart of this reality. In fact, everything that science talks about is nothing but exploring causation. How are objects and events linked? Can we find some kind of regularity here? Produce a law that can give some kind of, if you like, a handle on it? That's what science is all about. So, whatever, when we talk about religion or science, we are really in a way trying to grapple with the law of cause and effect. And we recognize the complexity. It's hidden in complexification. So many millions of things combine together, conspire is the right word, together, and produce one effect. You can't give a simply saying that I must have done something bad in my past life. I must have taken somebody else's eye out, so my eye is taken out this year. This is very oversimplistic. Things add up. Sometimes they add up in a very nasty way. They push us in the corner. The only thing the law of karma tells you is this. It says, look, things will conspire against you. You can lose your eyesight. You know, you can have family problems. And we know much more serious problem than even losing your eyesight. People dying. You know, we have cases, and we are suffering, struggling. So, Dilipbhai, what have we done wrong that we suffer from this, you know, disease which is going to take our lives? What do we do? The answer is this, my friend. You roll up your sleeves and come fighting. Take it head on. Things are going to come against you. You'll be pushed in a corner. Never become a fatalist. Never say, I must have done something bad in my past life, so it's catching up. Don't do that. Vivekananda would be really annoyed with this. No, roll up your sleeves and say, things conspire against me, good for them, let them come. I'm in charge of my destiny. And even if I have to fight the whole of this nature, I will fight nature, because this is how you express the spirit. The spirit is not in conformity with external forces saying, okay, I play dead, you can, you know, hit me. It says, I'll fight back. We harness spirit external. If you like, harness forces external and harness forces internal, and if you like, keep them both under control and reveal our divinity. This is the definition of religion from Swami Vivekananda. So do not let things kind of pull you down. Come fighting. And never blame yourself or others. Why? Things conspire. Things, millions of things add up for one result to take place, and I did not have any control on most of this. So why should I take the blame? Just be open. The only thing law of karma teaches us, which we have forgotten, is this. Come fighting, whatever the circumstances. Do not blame anybody or yourself. Do not even be indifferent to your own suffering, or become more crucially indifferent to the suffering of others. You see, in modern India, this message I'm repeating almost in every episode. Let it be repeated until it becomes ingrained in the Hindu society. The Hindus have forgotten the second dimension of the law of karma, which says if you see an issue in front of you that needs to be sorted out, suppose you see people suffering, struggling, poverty, and you turn your back saying, oh, they deserve it, law of karma. you are going to get whacked. Because the law of karma says if you see an issue in front of you and you do not take steps, then that is bad law of karma. You really not understood. It's going to come and bite you. So you need to immediately address the issue. Not only what you do is going to catch up with you, what you fail to do is going to come and catch up with you too. We all know that, don't we? We forget to check our oil and water in our car and we go for a long drive and we soon find out. So it's going to catch up and bite us on the backside. So this is what we are saying. Look, whenever I talk of Swami Vivekananda, one thing that will come out is this. He's a messenger of strength. He's the Hanuman of modern age. And I tell the Hindu youth, look, I like you to sing Hanuman Chalisa. Keep doing it. I don't mind. I love Hanuman. But grow up. You got a modern hero. You like the ancient one? He's good. Very good. You got a modern one. The only difference is no tail this time. But this one will catch your attention and give you real direction. The three things, Balla, Buddhi, Brahmacharya, is what Vivekananda stands for. And this is the source of strength. You invoke these three in your life. Take on the challenges head on. Do not be a wimp. Stand up and take on the challenges of this life. And you see how it transforms your life as well as the life of others.